It's just Mount Vernon, because that's where I actually live. Hometown.
How in the fuck are you about to say? The way that we do it, it's not the way. No, don't you swear that you're not in the way. Nothing you do compared in my day. Cash is fuck on my bed, I lay. Look at the ceiling, it fade away. Stressing and checking on me for a blessing, but I can hear nothing, I'm gone for the day. Sure, you can afford that, I get it. Looking like a bomb, only think I'm holding pennies. Pull out your mortgage, just spend it in a minute.
Hey, what's up, guys? Back with another video. I know it's been about a month since I did the last video on the install for the transmission stuff, but just wanted to give you guys a sort of like an end of the year video. I'm probably gonna film another video today before I put up this video, which is just gonna be like a little walk around video or whatever of what's done to the E30 since I haven't done one since 2017 or 2018, 2017, I think it was 2 years ago. So I just want to give a little bit of update of what the car is looking like right now for people that don't know or who don't follow the channel too much. But I'm just gonna do that, and I'm also going to throw on some new windshield banners that I got. I'm gonna be putting them up at the first of the year. I'm gonna throw that on real quick, and then I'll get the car started up with the battery in it, and then take it outside. It's December 17th right now, so it's kind of cold out. It's probably around 40 or 35 with the sun out, so it's not too bad right now, but it's not, you know, fucking warm out either. So let's go ahead and get this banner on, and then I'm gonna get some wheel dollies from my friend here. Probably this week coming up, once he ever finds the other fucking one. But I'm gonna get some wheel dollies so I can put the car on wheel dollies so I can move it around when it's in storage, when it's not started with a battery in it. Also, I got an episode coming up of the cluster being rebuilt, but that won't be happening until next year because they're booked until about, I think he said end of January. So getting a full cluster rebuild and doing a few things to the cluster. So that's gonna be one of the first episodes for next year that has to do with any kind of install video. But like I said, that won't be until the end of January. So I just wanna go ahead and give you this video to watch, just winterizing the E30. Since it's my second year on bags, I'm just gonna winterize the E30 right now and get it ready for the long haul, cause it's gonna be in here for you know, probably 5 or 6 months. So hopefully we can get it looking good next year. Didn't really have too much time this year because I've been spending a lot of money on the daily, like I said, and other videos. Just been fucking taking all my money, but enough rambling. I'm gonna get this banner real quick, show you guys what the banner looks like. Then if you guys want one, you can pick one up on my Big Cartel, which I'll leave linked down below always. So let's get to it. Alright guys, so the new banner's on. Got these guys' chariot ones I've been wanting to make for a while, just decided to get around to it. So I have these gonna be in stock at the beginning of the year, probably like the first week of January. I'm just gonna order like 5 or 6 off the bat, and then I'll just you know, get them as I need them. So he's gonna be up on the Big Cartel that's linked down below for my E30 Mafia page. I'm also gonna get some more E30 Mafia ones made. So I don't have to worry about people just complained about one design type. So these are gonna be up for sale by probably like the first week of January, and I'm gonna go ahead and be able to start doing some more merch here over the winter time. I want to try to do some shirts and stuff, but really haven't got around to it. But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and pack everything up, come back this weekend, and take some product shots for the banners for Instagram. And then I'm gonna have, like I said, I'm gonna get those wheel dollies for each wheels and buying them. My friend says he doesn't use them, they're just sitting on his fucking, I was gonna buy them new, but they're just sitting on his, like his stand or whatever at home. So just gonna go ahead and put the car on those after I film the videos outside. And then it's just gonna be sitting here for like the next, you know, few months, cause I'm not doing the transmission swap until probably late winter, early spring. I just gotta get all the rest of the parts. Like I said, obviously the transmission is all done. I just need to get the lightweight flywheel and then all the stuff for the motor I need to get. All the grounding cables, new alternator, new master cylinder, all kinds of shit that's, you know, small stuff, but needs to be done the same time the motor is being done, so. All right, guys, so I'm back in storage. Had the car turned around from what I did last time because I went out and drove it for a little bit, but
basically just gonna do a few things to the car to get her winterized, and just picked up these for my buddy, some wheel dollies, so the car can sit on these wheel dollies. It also puts a lot less stress on your tires, so you don't get flat spots when it sits for an extended period of time. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get the car started up, back it out, and then fucking back it back in, and then I'll put the car on those tomorrow. But right now I'm just gonna clean up the body, clean up the inside. I got all my clean stuff over here. Just want to give it a nice detail before it goes away for, you know, however long, a couple months. So I got some Griot's Garage Best of Show detailer, which is going to go outside of the car, obviously. Got some Black Shine tire gloss that's going to go on the tires after I get the wheels waxed. And then I just got some interior cleaner and some interior detailer. So we're going to get to the inside looking all nice and everything. Just got some new tools, so I just wanted to try out a few things. As you can see, I'm using my fucking Bluetooth speaker right now. But got the tiles for the window, so I could do all those, even though I already did the front because I put the banner on. So I'm going to do the rest of the windows. I'm not going to do the inside because the inside of the fucking windows, like I said before, the tint is pretty much coming off. So this was on the car when I first got it, so it needs to come off because somebody, whoever had it, started using the wrong kind of stuff on it and basically caused it to, you know, start deteriorating. So, but basically I'm just gonna clean the car, get everything all clean, clean the trunk setup, drain the air tank, even though it should be down pretty low right now because of the leak, because I'm gonna be taking the tank out to get the leak fixed and do the hard lines and shit, and changing the tank color. So hopefully I can get that done probably February sometime. And then I'm just gonna work on some other small things. I'm also gonna get a list right now of all the extra things I'm gonna need for the 5-speed swap, because I'm trying to do everything at once. So I gotta figure out what all crap I need for the motor, for gaskets and everything. So let's see, for Christmas I got a little LED panel light that goes on the camera. I just can't use it right now because I don't have my adapter to run the mic and this at the same time, but pretty bright for what it is. So when I'm doing the fucking video, you guys can see everything's all lit up. So definitely really like that I got this. So that's gonna be coming out. The whole process takes like a month, so it's gonna be one video, but it won't be filmed until the end of the month, and then the episode won't come out until, you know, probably the end of February. But enough talking, let's get this car started up. Got the battery in it, get her started up, get her backed up, and make sure everything lines up so I can get ready to jack the car up tomorrow and do a good little cleaning today. And then I'll probably fucking let all the air out of the tank tomorrow so I can get all of the moisture out of the tank and all the air. So damn, guys, I forgot I had the fucking camera rolling. It's been rolling for like 8 minutes by itself, but look at this shit. More fucking transmission fluid leaked all over, which is retarded. Then we got, let's see, oil right here. And then we got, what is that? It's fucking antifreeze. So that's one of the main reasons I'm taking the fucking motor out of this car. It has like 275 on it right now. So when I get my cluster done, I'm getting the odometer changed because I pinpointed it at about 275 just by all the calculations I've done over the years. So we're at about 275. Of course, you can't know the exact number, but whatever. But I'm gonna go ahead and get all the glass cleaned first, do the glass, and then I'll probably do the body, because I'm using that fucking Best of Show detailer, so I'm gonna use that. Really nice stuff. And then I'll do the wheels tomorrow when I jack up the car and everything. I'll do those tomorrow. And then as far as the setup in here, I'm not really touching anything because, like I said, when I pull the motor out to do the transmission swap, I'm pulling the whole fucking motor. So I'm taking every fucking gasket that I can get and doing all new gaskets. Let's see, where the oil filter mounts on the body or on the motor, that's leaking. So there's like a gasket set for that. So I'm gonna get gaskets for those. New oil pan gasket, new rear main seal, pretty much all the seals I can do on the motor to stop everything from leaking. Plus I'm gonna get that little fucking sensor, the blue sensor, the coolant sensor, get that put in because I got that. I'm getting my other valve cover painted, or sorry, not paint. I'm gonna get powder coated. So I'm gonna see if that's gonna be the color that I'm gonna wanna go for. If it is, the valve cover, the new wheels I'm building, and my tank color is all gonna be the same, all the same gold. So I'm trying to keep the gold theme within the car because I've really like the gold overall. But I'm gonna go ahead and get these fucking windows cleaned outside and clean up this fucking mess down here. And like I said, come back tomorrow and do the rest of it. I'm gonna put some stabilizer in the gas tank. I was gonna take the car down to get some gas, but with the transmission slipping, I literally can't even go anywhere. So there's no point to put transmission fluid in it when it's just gonna leak all over as soon as I fucking get back. So we're just gonna go ahead and get this fucking shit cleaned up and then see what shit looks like after. What's up, guys? Back over here. It's been a couple days. Just got off fucking work super late last night trying to get the job done. So it's about 7:30 right now, so it's kind of freezing in here, so I just want to kind of get this show on the road. So I'm just gonna go ahead and jack it up, put on the wheel dollies on the back, put the wheel dollies on the front, air it down to the ride height a little bit, and then clamp that little mess over there, the fucking bullshit, so I can push the car over here so I can see how I actually easy it is to push the car when it has the wheel dollies on it. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that real quick, get that done, and then I'll focus on doing these wheels real quick, get that, and then I can drain the air tank fully so all the water is out of it, so no water getting the manifold or anything like that, or freezes up or any of that bullshit. So I'm gonna drain that, have everything done. I usually you know, fill up all the fluids in the car for the winter time, but honestly, like I said, when the car is going to be getting swapped here in about a month, or not a month, probably about 2 or 3 months, towards the end of the spring, before the spring, so the end of the winter, I'm just going to go ahead and do all the motor shit. So there's no point, you know, to do all that filling up shit when it just leaks everything. So let's get this bitch jacked up and put the wheel dollies on it and get the other ones on the front. Let me know what you guys think. I'm probably going to, for the 5-speed swap video, I'm probably going to, you know, break it up into like 3 or 4 videos because it's going to be more than just swapping the transmission, like I said. So instead of having like one big video, you know, that's like 30 or 40 minutes long. If you guys, you know, want more in-depth stuff, I'll just give you guys like 3 different episodes at the same time. But let's get this car jacked up because it's fucking freezing in here. We'll be right back. So the car's all up, it's all fucking wrapped up, it's all ready for its winter sleep, at least for a few months. Love how clean it looks, all the wheels all polished and everything, but like I said, everything's all done. So like I said, the next episode of install, install wise, will be the like I said, the cluster rebuild. So at the end of the month, end of January, I'm sending that out. And then he said it takes about 3 to 4 weeks to complete everything. So hopefully it looks pretty sick when it comes back. And maybe if you guys want to get your cluster done, you guys will have somebody to ask questions to or whatever, since I'm getting it done. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching the vlog. Like I said, I'm just trying to give you guys a little bit of content just for now. I'm probably going to do a little update video on the 5-speed swap, all the parts that I'm gathering or whatever, because I'm about to order a flywheel from a friend on Friday. So that'll be close to the last things to get for the actual 5-speed swap itself. I still need to get, I might have to get a new clutch assembly and everything. So like I said, because I have a clutch and a flywheel over here, it's like a couple thousand miles on it, but I'm not really sure the condition of it, and I'm not really sure if it actually fits the car. So fits the new transmission flywheel or whatever. So not too versed on it, honestly. So like I said, I'm probably just gonna split the entire install video up for about probably like 4 episodes or 3 episodes, and not have one big long episode and cut out a lot. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to check all the links down below. Be sure to check out my past install videos. And like I said, this year hopefully is going to be a great year for the E30 build. So anyways, guys, later.